another loaf, another day. This bread I've been making since the 80s. We'll see how it works in the Pullman tin. This is called Awake Bread, and this should make two loaves. It makes two eighters for me if I do it in pans. So what I have in here are 4.5 teaspoons of yeast. I'm going to go ahead and put it in the bowl with water that is 100 degrees. It's 2 cups of water. Okay? Just let it stay until it dissolves. And I'll be back. So anyway, this is filtered water. Chlorine and yeast don't get along. Okay? So I'm using, in this recipe, all of my flour will be unbleached. Now, the flour that I'm going to use is a mixture of bread flour and all-purpose flour, cheap all-purpose flour. You can use any flour you want. If you want to do all whole wheat, go ahead. If you want to do all bread, go ahead. You want to do all-purpose, go ahead. If you want to do some of this and some of that, go ahead. It's your bread. So I'm going to add Captain Hook to the mix here. Here's my thing. And I'll raise the bowl up. And I'll stir it in. Now once it's dissolved and looking dissolved, you get to add 2.5 cups of flour. In here, I have 2 cups of bread flour, a scant 2 cups of bread flour. And I made up the difference with all-purpose flour. So I need 2.5 cups of any kind of flour. So now it's fairly well mixed. And we have to let it rise till double. How do you know when it's till double? If you're using a mixer like this, you can see that'll be about double. So when it hits there, we'll start the rest of the recipe. Meanwhile, I'm back at the farm. I have 2 cups of all-purpose flour in here. I have a lot of all-purpose flour that I want to use up. A lot of flour. Every time Hungry goes to the store, he brings me flour. He says, I know you bake so much, but yes, I do bake so much, but I don't bake that much. I don't have a bakery, although that's a thought. Anyway, I've got 2 cups in here. If we need a little less than 2 cups, we'll just put it in gradually. If we need a little more, we can always scoop it out of the bucket and add it. So after this has done its double, we're going to add the extra flour, a little at a time. And, I'll probably start with just holding back 1/4 cup or so. And, we'll mix them very well. And when you get enough flour mixed in, we'll start adding other things. Oh yeah, I'd say it's double. Now we're going to add 1/4 cup of sugar, 1/4 cup of shortening, and a 1/2 teaspoon? Nope, 1 teaspoon of table salt. There we go. And mix it. Makes it good. Scrape it down. There's still little lumps in there from the shortening. That's okay. Can you do this by hand? Yep. The actual recipe was written for doing it by hand. Can you do it in a bread machine? Yep, If you just make enough dough to fit in your bread machine and follow their directions for weight bread or wheat bread, depending on the flour you put in. Now, let's see how sticky. That's sticky, but that's not too bad. That's what we want. Tacky and a little sticky. If it's not sticky, it's good. But a little bit sticky is desirable. So now I'm going to dump it into my well-oiled bucket, dough bucket, or a bowl with a lid, whatever. Put Captain Hook in the sink. Oh, this is so heavy. Heavy. Let's see if I can get it in there. Man, oh shit, it's don't get old. You're gonna use a bowl. This is like something you'd see on a cartoon. If you're going to use a regular bowl, and you need to cover it, so use some stretch tight, but go ahead and grease the stretch tight. Give it a little spray of safflower oil or something. I like the dough buckets because stuff doesn't tend to stick in them. I do a lot of stuff with these dough buckets, including storing things. But when I say dough bucket, I'm talking about something that doesn't have a real tight lid. If it does seem to have a tight lid, don't put it on tight. Leave it kind of what Julia Child would call akimbo. Just, you know, whatever. Okay, now you can either... Come on, dough. This is a little over... a liter. Where are you? It's right there. A liter, okay? So when it gets up to 2 liters, we'll be good. That'll be doubled. How long will it take till it's done? That's how long it takes. My kitchen is today. Let's see what it is. Almost 80. Why? I had the oven on for something. So I got... Can you see that? There we go. It's almost 80. So I started out, it was just a little bit over 1 liter. So I'll let it go till it's a little bit over 2 liters. Wow, it's just been about 20 minutes. And it's rising fast. In my very warm kitchen. So let it deflate. Punch the gas out of it. It says to knead it lightly into 2 loaves. Well, the old recipe would have been like 4 loaves, but okay. I'm going to just do half of it. I put too much oil in here, so. Kneading it will help get out any air bubbles, there's a lot of them, and help you get the shape you want. I don't want to put any more flour on it, so slap it in the pan. I don't know if this is enough dough, really, for a 9-inch Pullman. Now the directions will say to let it rest a few minutes till the oven is preheated. I've already started preheating my oven, but I know at 425 it takes almost 20 minutes to get my pizza stone hot enough. So I always have the pizza stone in there. So now you're going to have a 325 degree oven and bake these for 1 hour. Oven's hot. So far, so good. I don't know. Okay, in 2 minutes. This one I'll dump out. Looks like Hungry Hubby's going to get another bread pudding. Kind of wonky looking. Doesn't weigh a thing. It's very light. It does seem to come out better when I make it in a big loaf rather than an eater. This feels, I don't know. Okay, I'm taking out the pan de mie. Right out. Nice, isn't it? I think it came out just ducky. So, we'll let it cool. You know, hot bread equals a bellyache or a smack with the wooden spoon because it's still kind of cooking. You don't want to eat hot breads unless it's supposed to be hot, like pancakes, tortillas. Alrighty, I'll let that sit for a while. Gee, look how nice and square it is. This came out much better than I expected, but we'll see when it cools down. I'm going to take its picture, send it to Hungry Hubby. Well, it's pretty, but Hungry Hubby doesn't think it makes good toast. We'll try another one. I like it.